Hello folks, and welcome back to SnowRunner, my speed run that I'm attempting. And we are on day number 6 of the speed run. Have a few things planned for today. If we can get this truck moving. So some of the things I have planned are, I am going to go get a bunch of upgrades that are on this map, mostly the ones for either the GMC or for the Western Star. I am also, I'll show you here on the map, I am over in this area of the map because I am heading over to here so I can go to Island Lake, and I am pulling this with me because while I'm at Island Lake I am going to or no I'm sorry I take that back I'm pulling this with me because there's another GMC up here that I have to fix up, and I'm going to fix up that GMC, and I'm going over to I'm doing that because I need the money to make sure I have enough to buy another one of these once I get to Island Lake so that I can go over and get the twin steer. Then once I've gotten upgrades here, I'm going and over on Island Lake because there's a couple over there I need to pick up. Then I'm going to Drummond Island. So, one upgrade I need to pick up there, which is the SnowRunner gears for most of the big vehicles, and pick up the P16. So a lot to try to accomplish today. I don't know if I will get it all done in this day, but we will give it a try. If not, there is always tomorrow. So right up here is the GMC that I've got to fix up. And I don't remember if I need gas with this or not. But since I was over in this area anyway, I figured I would go ahead and tow this trailer over here. Yeah, I think it just needs repair points. All right, that's $4,000 more. And they did fix that, so it disappears now. And I'm going to attempt to pull this over toward Island Lake. Right now I really don't have the traction, so I'll pull it as far as I can. But if it starts bogging me down too much, isn't there a winch point? There's a tree right there. So I like going this way because I avoid that big mud hole over there. And once the trucks are fully upgraded, you can go through here a lot faster. But I am only at day 6 in this speed run, so I don't have very good trucks with good upgrades yet. And I am working on it. Which is the reason I decided to come over here and get the P12. Or get the P16 and then sell it and get the P12. I like the P12 better than the P16. Only because it is more versatile. I can do a lot more with it. And with it, I can easily get the Western Star. Come on, pull me through. Tires are the big thing right now. I believe I have the all-terrain tires on here. And with the mud tires, this would run a lot better. Also with the SnowRunner gears. I didn't pay any attention to see if the wolf was out. Usually the wolf is right down in there. Right down in the mud. I'll go ahead and take this on over. I don't believe that I can fix the GMC up and fix up the twin steer with one maintenance trailer. I don't remember how many it takes for the twin steer. Get my camera back here a little bit. But we will go try. Let me see how many I do have. I have 975. I don't think that's enough. I think it's like something like 980. But whatever it is, it's not enough. And I believe I've already went the wrong way, didn't I? Yes, I did, because I was supposed to go that way. Let's do this the easy way. Where's my dot? Yeah, and it does not want to turn. Let's see where my hitch is. slip over your stand. And I think what I'm going to do is go ahead and drop the trailer off here. And then actually go over and get a full trailer. Just in case, so I don't have to make another trip back here. If that's not enough. And since I'm doing it, accept all the tasks on the way. It's Hunter Bob's Bridge. So there's a trailer store over here on the left. Whoop. Front end caught really fast. And then you come up here and make a right. And you flip the truck over. Keep flipping, keep flipping, keep flipping. Shoot. Okay. Back to Smithville. And we are going to get the Chevy first. And I will come back out and get that truck when I make my trip over here to go to Drummond Island. And I will flip that truck back over. Right now, driving all the way out there just to flip the truck over, just be wasting time. So we'll recover you. And I did get another Chevy, didn't I? Yep. So retain that and sell that one. So the Lodestar, leave the garage. Oh, wait a minute. Can I get upgraded tires on it? I think I can. I'm at level 6, yes. Get the lower powers because they seem to work better than the other two. And got my fuel cans in the back. Yeah, might as well go. And pick up the upgrade over here. So there's an upgrade at the T intersection, make a right. And it will give me a bigger engine for the Chevy. I think it is the 4.4 engine. And it's also an upgrade for F750 and something else, and I don't remember what else it was. Might be for the Scout, but I'm thinking it's not the Scout. I think it's three different trucks. I need my suspension lift for this thing. So, truck list. Oh, four different ones. All for the, yeah, for the Scout. And, I guess, for the Apache. Might as well recover it. Because I need to run it. And our little Russian buddy. So where are you at? There you are. Oh. That's still good enough. And for right now, I'm running these two in tandem because the Lodestar has extra fuel. And I just don't like driving the Russian one. Still yet, as you're driving down the road in this thing, it veers off to the right or left for no apparent reason. It does okay when you're not on the hard road or you're not going fast. So it just makes it easier to tow it where I need it to go. And the gas tank's small. My first couple of playthroughs, I didn't use the Con Marshall at all. And because I just don't like the way it drives. But now I've figured out the best way to use it. And that's to tow it behind something else. Tow it to where I need it, and then let it do its thing. Still, I get some good mud tires on the Lodestar and get the suspension lift. It's not the best it can be. I know there's an upgrade out that way, but it's not one that I need right now. So, not going to fool with it. And we will be going down here later to get the Western Star. But I need the P12 first. So our first upgrade is on the other side of the bridge and to the left. I think it's the other side of the bridge. It might be the other side of the dam. It's the other side of the dam. It should be right up here on my left. Somewhere up here. Right there it is. Maybe the engageable. Yep, engageable all-wheel drive. And it's just for the Western Star. My next one is up near the turnoff for the quarry. There's actually two upgrades up that way. I only need the one, but I'll pick up the other one while I'm there. Save me from having to come back out that way. Now we also have to get the international, the cab over, so I'll get it along the way. I'll get that when I come back. I'm on a time crunch. Also got a trailer over there to discover. And by pulling the Con Marshall, it used almost no gas. Alright, so let's see if I can remember how to get here. And let's see if I can do it without flipping this thing over. Or tearing it up. I would bring the load star up here, but the load star takes a lot of damage when it goes through here. It's not high enough and it bounces off the rocks. So I believe up here is an upgrade. It's not the one I need, but I'll get it while I'm here. Yeah, still trying to get used to this new controller. As I said in my last video, my other controller finally died on me. And I've been looking for another wireless controller and can't find one. Oh yeah, freeway gears. For all of those. And I don't run the freeway gears, so... But I couldn't find a wireless controller, so I ended up with a wired one, and it just doesn't feel right. Can I go down here? Yeah, that's where I need to go. And the fact the way I've got my setup with a wired controller, I actually have to sit in my chair at the desk, where with the wireless I could sit in my recliner and I'm much more comfortable. But we do what we can. Trying to take it a little bit easy because I don't want to have to come out here and rescue it. Because I need it for the next part. So if you haven't been following this, what I'm doing is seeing how fast I can finish each region by doing careful planning, doing multiple loads at once, trying not to have an empty vehicle. So I'll do a mission delivering something, and then right nearby I'll pick up something else to do another mission. And I have been doing that, but what I'm doing now is I'm going after the P16 and the upgrades for the vehicles, because I think in the long run upgraded vehicles will help me finish this map faster than to get all the upgrades as I get to each map. Okay, so raise suspension for the Western Star. And recover it. And then here's where I need you. And I'll get you back out. Because this will end up being faster than driving it back out of there to where the load star is, and driving the Con Marshall all that way will just cost me time, because of its tendency to just veer off one to the right or left at any given time. Plus I need to pick up the trailer that I left up here. The first 3 days that I did in this run, I did before update 7.0 came out. And then I played the 7.0 till I finished it with the Amandra map, and coming over here and doing the big loads here in my other playthrough. And where I had left it was, this truck had come over and got the bridge open down here. But when I got on this again earlier today to do day number 4, the trailer was still down there where I opened up the bridge, but the truck was back in the garage. And I never took the truck back to the garage, so I don't know what happened. So sometime in that 2 weeks that I was doing Amandra, the game decided to put my truck back in the garage for me. Old Smokey. Yeah, I think I need to work on this controller a little bit. I think I was so used to my other controller, and it was actually having some issues, but I was so used to it that my joystick for my maps, or for my view that I'm doing, looking around the map here, is moving a little bit too fast. So I'm going to have to slow that down just a hair. So what I'm doing on this speed run, I'm running it on a 24-hour basis. That way it helps me keep track of the amount of time that I've spent. And for the YouTube videos, I'm doing each video. Let's go ahead and fill up. Refuel. That's what I wanted. So fill that one up and fill up Con Marshall. And yeah, stop the engine. And let's see if I can, from the Lodestar, okay, pick up chassis, Con Marshall, Lodestar, so it won't let me do it. Oh, Navistar, there we go. So put the Navistar at top and fill up my, yeah, I can do that. Okay. Give me some, a couple of tanks of gas here. Come on. There we go. Well, poop. I forgot I gotta go back down the hill. So yeah, what I've been doing is running it from 6 a.m. to 6 a.m. is a day. And that will help me keep track of how long it takes me to clear the maps. So again, this is day 6. I did one playthrough. I was doing it already. And I was at day 17. And actually, accidentally saved over it because I was going to start a new game with co-op mode, and accidentally started a new game over my other save file, so I had to start this all over again. And then update 7.0 came out, so I've been playing that. So, well, get out of the way. Well, poop. All right, now we got it. So the Lodestar actually struggles coming through here since it is not upgraded. So the Con Marshall has no problem. So it can pull the Lodestar through this area. Now, once I get the suspension lift on the Lodestar and get good tires, it goes through here like it's nothing. I've got an upgrade over here. I don't need this upgrade, but since I'm over here, so that's the race suspension for the Scout. And I don't drive the Scout. I don't like it because it's too tippy. So the next thing we're going to do is get the... I forgot an upgrade. I'll get it when I get back. Next thing I'm going to do is come over here and get that vehicle. But I'm going to get this heading that way, so I don't forget where my little slot is that I go through. Let's get you recovered. This is so much easier than my hardcore mode. Hardcore mode, I can't recover anything to the garage. I have to drive everything back. If I flip something over, I have to send something else out to flip it back. So go through the slot here. Oh, camera. The joysticks on the new controller are really sensitive, much more sensitive than I'm used to. So it's going to take me a little bit to get used to them. Even on muddy ground, the con marshals sometimes will just take off to one side or the other. But right now it is the best mud vehicle that I have. A little bit further. See if we can see Wolfie up here. There he is. That's actually only one of two wolves that I have found so far in the game. From what I understand, there are a bunch of wolves out here. I've never really paid any attention. So the one upgrade I forgot was for the GMC, and it's on the top of a mountain, and we will get it when we come back over here. Leave you here and go get our fleet star turned back over. So I flipped the Fleet Star over earlier because I was going back to, I was coming over here to buy another maintenance trailer to make sure I had enough points to get the twin steer. And ended up flipping it over. So I don't know if I can. Probably can't flip it back this way, so. Let's knock some trees down. Yeah, it almost rolled back on the wheels. It was really close. So hey there, was it Dougal211? How you doing this evening? Alright, get you turned around. I forgot there was a trailer here. Fuel carrier. Nope. That's what I wanted. And I want you. Just to make sure I have enough repair points. Because as I said in the last video, I used a repair trailer that was over near the GMC. And nubs this. No, it was this video. Sorry. Sometimes videos run together. But use a repair trailer over there to do the GMC, and I don't believe there was enough. I think it'd be like 5 points short or 10 points short of being able to do the twin steer. Shoot, I'm about to roll it over again. Not paying attention to what I'm doing. Hit a tree. Don't think I actually had the bumper I think I might have had the side of the truck. But I've got it now. I'm going to need fuel also for the twin steer, and there is a tanker on the next road over. And hopefully this will work. I did, in one of my playthroughs, I came out here and I could not, well actually I fixed up the twin steer, I fueled up the twin steer, and it wouldn't let me have the twin steer. I had to start that mission all over again. But the second time I did the mission, it actually worked. Hopefully I won't have any issues this time. And we got our watchtower up here. Upgrade discovered. I don't remember what this upgrade was, but I think I need it. It's up here on the other side of the twin steer. I believe it is off to my right there. Oh, there it is. It was up here somewhere. And there's our twin steer. Which right now I'm going to, as soon as I get it back, I'm going to sell it for the money, but eventually I will be buying it back when we get to Alaska. Found it quite useful in Alaska. Yeah, I do have to put fuel in it. So let's get it repaired first. 760. Oh, I did have enough in the other. Well, waste a little bit of time. Because I think I did have enough in the other trailer. What did I need? 96 gallons. So yeah, I'm going to have to go get that trailer. Oh, shoot. test trailer. And unfortunately, I gotta go back on the road and go around. If this was fully upgraded, I could cut right through the middle. I believe it is over in there somewhere. Actually, I think there might be enough trees over there to get through using my winch. Let's take a look at the map. Yeah, because there's my trailer that I need. I can't go this way because the bridge is out. But when I get over here, I'll look at it. See if there's enough trees to pull me through, because I do not have good tires for this. And there might be. I also don't have the extended winch on here yet. Or a snorkel. There we go. Yeah, it might have been easier to just go around. That's what I'll probably do coming back. Stuck on a tree. go with that one. Winch seems to work better when you attach it to the back than it does from the front. Where's my trailer? There we go. We're cooking with grease now. So, masked grandpa, yeah, it's kind of a contradiction. SnowRunner SpeedRun. But I was just curious if, you know, how long it would take to clear the maps if you did careful planning. So, thought I'd give it a try till the next update comes out. It was actually something I was doing waiting on the 7.0 update, and as I said earlier, it was I was 17 days into it and I accidentally saved over the profile that I was using, so I had to start it all over again, and then 7.0 come out. But now I'm finished with Imandra, so really not a lot to do until phase 2 comes out. So I thought I'd give this a go and see what happens. Yeah, Imandra was hard mode on fire. But I tell you what, I would do Imandra 10 times before I would ever do the those two new things they put in for the bobbleheads. I will never do those again. I don't care if they give me a free truck, I will never do them again. That was hell. Come on. I'm stuck on that tree again. Back up a little bit, it goes away. Yeah, still trying to get used to this new controller. So you haven't done Imandra yet? Imandra is... it was a pain in the butt when I first started it because I tried to do the maps, or I tried to open the map up and go all around the map with scout vehicles. If I had to do it again, I would not use a scout vehicle. I would just use a heavy truck. I'm about out of gas. I would get a big truck and just pull a scout vehicle around with that. And the scout vehicle attached to the radar unit to open the map up. I think that would have been a lot easier and actually a lot more fun. I was looking at the chat here and wasn't watching where I was driving. I've got everything in a different spot because my controller broke. And now the only controller I could find was a wired one, so I have to sit at my desk now instead of my nice little setup that I had with my easy chair. So it looks like 6:42, so we are done with day 6 and we have moved into day 7.